I speak unto thee this day, and I say, when you see men and women in the desolation of their debauchery, that is, in the aftermath of the same, I say, take advantage of that. That is, take advantage of their misery, their calamity, take advantage of their depression and despair, and I say, tell them of me. For I say, it is me, the living God, who is calling all men to repent, no matter what condition they are in. And I say, when you see them in the aftermath of their delusion, I say, it is the time to declare my kingdom, declare their need to repent, and call them unto me. Now I say, this day you are living in times when men have everything that their fat hearts could ever desire, yet I say they are desolate of soul. And I say they are desperately needy of repenting, of running into me and partaking of my life. And I say they are desperately needy of knowing that it is me, the living God alone, who is able that they could indeed be subject to me. That is, that they could be brought forth in the redemptive mercies that I provide. For I say it is me, the living God, who is the way of all righteousness, the way of all truth, and the way that is mercy provided. And I say, when a people will believe upon me, cleave to me, and come forth in me, then I say they are guided forth in my life. And yes, they are given the truth, the light, the strength, the mercy of who I am. For it is me, the living God, who is ever present to give to them the same. And yes, they are uplifted, directed, and instructed in the truth of who I am. Now I say this day, when I, the living God, do give the call to repentance, revolution, it is that men would turn from sin. For I say that the wages of sin is death, that has always been, it will always be. And I say, when men are indulging themselves repeatedly in sin and sin and sin again, no, they are living in death. And I say, they will face the physical death and go and perish in sin, that is, to be found in hell, remembered no more. But I say, when men and women will repent of those sins and turn from the same, then I say they are able to walk uprightly in me. Now I say that I've told you, I will repeat it unto you again, that when men are pushed down by their circumstance, their situation, by that which is darkness and evil looming on the horizon, by the iniquity of their own hearts, by the evil that they are doing, I say it is the call for them to repent. That is, it is me, the living God, who allows the pressures to come upon men, that they will indeed look at their wickedness, look at their evil, look at their endless cycle of darkness and desire to come out of the same. For I say it is me, the living God, who delights when men will see the error of their way and thoroughly repent and run into me. But I say, when men will continue in the way of darkness and sin, the way of evil and iniquity, then I say they will be found bound in the same. That is, if they refuse the call to repentance, then I say they will only wax older and bolder in the filthiness of their own way. But I say, when men will take stock of their circumstance and situation, of their inward darkness and desire to be free of the same, then I say that they will repent before me. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do not want you to continue to complain, to gripe, and carry on about the times that you are in. But I say that I want you to see that I, the living God, can move and move and move by the power of my Spirit and draw men unto me. For I say that I, the living God, know exactly what men have need of, and yes, I'm allowing them to get the same. That is, in the sense of their misery, their affliction, their woe, because they have departed from me. And I say it is me, the living God, who allows them to not only gain the cup, but to drink it in the full. That is, that they would be so sickened by their sin, by their debauchery, contamination, and defilement, that they will cry out unto me. That is, that they will cry out for redemptive mercy, that they will cry out to be brought forth in the newness of life that I provide. For I say it is me, the living God, who is the way of all righteousness and truth, the way of mercy and hope, and the way that is peace provided. I say this day that I, the living God, do call you to be thankful that you can indeed see that I, the living God, am working and moving by the power of my Spirit day by day. I say, if I must bring evil tidings upon men for them to repent, then I say, be thankful unto me. For I say, it is me, the living God, who knows where men are living and what it is that they are doing. And I say that the misery of this present life is nothing to be compared with hell forever. For I say, when men are bound in the torments of hell, the agonies of the same, I say, there is no escape. And I say, there is no despotic emperor that can be pulled down, or irrational system of governing that will go away. For I say there is absolutely no hope of refuge to be found in hell. Therefore, I say, do not complain about what it is that I, the living God, am allowing to befall the sons of men. For I say, it is better that men will grow so utterly miserable that they will cry out in the agony of the same while they still have a chance to repent in this life. For I say, when men are found bound in hell, I say, that is where they remain. Therefore, I say, be thankful that it is me, the living God, who is effectively working to bring forth my purpose, my plan. That is, when you see the evil powers that have spread themselves in proud array, I say it is to cause men to tremble in the fear of the same. And I say it is to cause men to cry out unto me that they could indeed be repentant and be found redeemed. For I say, if men do not have pressure, they have grown so fat, so lazy, so complacent and comfortable, I say they will never cry out unto me. And I say they will indeed be found in hell because there was no repentance in their lives. Therefore, I say, do not begrudge me in bringing the pressures that must be brought to cause men to repent. But I say, be thankful that I, the living God, reign supreme, and I know what I do. For I say, you see what men have done with their so-called good times and prosperity. I say, they have utterly departed from me. And I say, they have grown so fatted, so full, so contemptuous towards me, that they literally hate my way. So I say, it is me, the living God, who will strip them. It is me, the living God, who will devastate them and cause them to cry out unto me. And of course, there will be the ones who will harden their hearts and stiffen their necks and refuse to repent. But I say that they will be damned in the same. I say this day that I, the living God, do not call you to mourn nor to weep over the so-called good times. For I say they have proven to be unhealthy in the sense that men chose the opportunity to back up from me. That is, they chose the goodness in the flesh, so to speak, above the life in the spirit. And what do you see? I say, you see that goodness in the flesh has become rottenness, decay, and filthiness. And I say, they pursue all manner of vulgarity while they abandon me. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do know the reprobate condition that men are in. And I say, it is by my mercy that I am allowing pressure upon them. And I say, you are not meant to begrudge me nor resent me when you see those pressures, for I say they are needful upon the dogs to cause them to repent. That is, to cause them to see the utter misery they have brought themselves unto by their departure from me, and to cause them to know at last that it is me that they need. For I say, it is me, the living God, who is really giving forth the ultimate mercy in calling men to repent. And I say, it is likewise my mercy to allow the pressures, the calamities, the cruelty of those oppressive powers to loom before them to cause them to repent. For I say, it is my desire that men and women would run wholeheartedly into me and embrace my way. And I say, it is me, the living God, who knows that if they are not freed from the prison house of their own laziness, complacency, comfort, and satisfaction in the flesh, that they will never groan for me. Therefore, I say, be thankful that I, the living God, am the one who sends forth the pressure, who sends forth the hardship, who sends forth the sorrow upon the souls of men. For I say that it is by my mercy that I have brought forth the times that ye are in. That is, in the sense that if men do not get shaken up out of their own vile and corrupted worlds, I say they will end in hell forever and live in the agony of the same. And it is me, the living God, who is sending unto them the pressure to cause them to cry out in repentance, repentance, repentance unto me. For I say, when men will start to repent, I say they open up the gateway to see what it is that they've done before me. That is, to see their utter wretchedness, their own inward darkness, and the evil that they are in. And to likewise see that the conditions of the times are the result of their abandonment of me. And I say, it is me, the living God, who is serious about repentance, revolution, and I say that I'm calling for the same. Therefore, I say, be thankful each day that you can indeed declare me, that you can indeed pray in accordance to my will, that you can indeed be bearing witness of me. And I say, testify one to another of what it is that I do, reminding yourselves that I, the living God, have good and not evil intended. But I say, when men will push and push and push against me, then I say they are the ones who bring the evil to themselves. And I say, when men have grown so proud, so impudent, so defiant, that they think they can hate me openly, that they think they can defy me, that they can destroy all that I am, and yet I with the same that I say it is me, the living God, who exercises retribution upon them. And I say that even that is sin to cause them to bow down, to humble themselves, and cry out unto me. For I say, if in even the most wicked of sinners will repent, that I, the living God, am able to give mercy. Now I say, this day be glad for the time that I, the living God, have given unto thee to call men to repentance, and I say, be active in the same. And even if you do not interact in the public with men, I say, be active in the prayers, the prayers, the prayers, calling all men to repent. For I say, it is me, the living God, who is able, it is me, the living God, who will bring forth, and it is me, the living God, who is in control. Therefore, I say, do not tremble at the agendas of the wicked, but I say, rejoice in me. For I say, it is me, the living God, who is higher than any power of men, and it is me, the living God, who shall prevail. And it is me, the living God, who can bring down the most proudest, the impudent, the cocky, the self-assured. I say that I can cause them to grovel in the dust. And I say, so it is likewise with global powers that strut themselves as though they remain forever, and all of their agendas of evil, I say I can bring them down. Therefore, I say, you are not meant to live in the fear that is intended for the ungodly, that is intended for the heathen, that is intended for the ones who have departed from me. But I say, you are meant to walk in the way of the upright, knowing that it is me, the living God, who is with thee. And I say, you are meant to stay steadfast, to call all men to repentance, revolution in me. That is, that they will be turned from the wickedness, the evil, the darkness of their own way, and brought forth in the way that I provide. That they will indeed be given the blessedness, the strength, the mercy of who I am. Therefore, I say, in a wayward, a vile, a corrupted and evil generation, let it be me that you continue to look unto and believe. And let it be me who is indeed the life source, the one who is able to direct thee always. Now I say, this day, when you look upon what it is that I, the living God, have intended, I say it is the way of abundance and mercy, the way of truth and life, and the way of goodness provided. And I say, when you really will look at that way, you will see it is me, the living God, who is able. Yes, it is me, the living God, who is well able to direct, correct, and guide forth as the people are truly repentant unto me. And it is me, the living God, who is able to give the humility way wherein my people are thankful, ever thankful to be governed by me. For I say that for too long my people have sought the governments of this world. They have had their faith in a nation that cannot say they have looked to that which I never intended for them to be ruled by. And I say, because they have taken on false coverings and false authorities, I say they have become false before me. But I say it is me, the living God, who will indeed strip them of all of the falsity, the vanity, to see where they stand. And I say that there will be those who will repent and change their ways. And I say, likewise, there will be those who harden the heart, stiffen the neck, and make their determination for hell. But no man can say that I did not give him the call to repent.
You're commanded by God to repent. You're commanded by God.